happens today. The lights go out. It's a good start from Aaron Canaan, actually on pole position. Jakob Kornfar from the second row got away well. Tatai, not so. From third, it will be Canaan that gets the whole shot.
Brilliant start by Alonso Lopez from sixth place. A career best start for the Spanish teenager. Stunning launch off the line. He got up to third place into turn one. Slipstream is going to be absolutely vital. The field weave and snake down this near 1,000 metre back straight, and Lopez does use the slipstream perfectly. Fires up the inside of Ayaguirre. Is he going to run in a little bit wide? No, he's not. He's going to pull it down. So Lopez up into second place. He started sixth. Good first lap for him on the Estrella Galicia 100. He's picked up four spots.
As Alonso Lopez comes through and takes the lead into turn 16.
Turn 15 then has caught out Jaume Massa. It's now no podium in eight for the 18-year-old Spaniard. His tough season gets even worse. Now Canet's going to get the good drive coming out of the final corner. Is he going to hold it on the brakes into turn one at the start of lap number three? They fan out almost four abreast. Canet does get it done. He got superb drive out of that turn 17 there. Did Canet to sweep back on through Lopez? There is Dalla Porta then, with his teammate Marcos Ramirez for company. Those two have had some pretty hot battles so far this year. And Lopez hits the front for the first time. He briefly led. Canet's going to get squeezed out wide. Lopez had the inside line. Canet couldn't turn in. He couldn't fight for the piece of tarmac he wanted. But look at the drive Canet gets coming out of 17 yet again. The rear grip on that KTM as Arbolino uses a two-bike slipstream. Not quite sharp enough on the brakes. Canet's brilliant on the brakes into the first corner as well. He still just about holds firm at the front.
Yeah, John McPhee is squeezed through now on Alonso Lopez and Ayaguirre as well. And Ayaguirre has just dropped another place as Suzuki comes through. The cream starting to rise to the top here in Moto3 in Aragon.
Marcos Ramirez has crashed. So he had a disastrous qualifying yesterday, Ramirez. 20th, he started this Aragon Grand Prix. His worst qualifying since the opening night in Qatar. And he's livid, really frustrated.
Suzuki's now pushing through on Arbolino. He can see Canet drifting off a bit here.
Yeah, he's got that inside line as well to attack Arbolino on the brakes into turn 12. He's got the job done there. Nicely done by Tatsuki Suzuki. So he's picked up two spots on this lap already, and he can see Canet just making a little bit of a break. Canet's advantage over the line was 0.7 seconds. And while this big group behind him are engaging in a pretty intense dogfight, this is just music to Canet's ears. He's got clear track in front of him. Nobody impeding him. He can just run his precise rhythm, and he can try and make a decisive break here, can Canet.
Alonso Lopez reluctant to fall any further back than third or fourth. A bit of an experience at times from Lopez as he barges out Tatsuki Suzuki to go up into second place. Tatsuki might just say, OK, well, if you can bring me in to Aaron, I'll follow you for a while. But
they've got a box clever here, this pack behind Aaron Canet, because they do know if they get engaged in a big dogfight, Canet already in the first sector on this current lap has taken almost 0.3 out of the pack behind him. Who's going to be latest on the brakes into turn 16? John McPhee we're on board with now, the Flying Scotsman. Just ahead of him is Tony Arbolino through this long 16, 17, then crucial to get good drive and acceleration out of this final corner. Set up a move going on into turn one on the brakes.
Yeah, it was indeed costly then for Suzuki. He dropped down to sixth there.
This group, Steve, on that last lap dropped into the 201s. They're running nothing like the pace of Canet. Canet on his lonesome can do 59s for fun. Behind him, jousting it out for second place, they're costing themselves, tripping over each other, costing themselves crucial time. Canet, by the end of this lap, is probably going to be well clear by over 3 seconds. It's his race to lose now.
Yeah, exactly, and he's riding within himself as well. It was a 58.1 he posted to get pole position here yesterday, Aaron Canet. So you feel like he's probably got a little more in his back pocket if he needs it as well. But right now he doesn't. 3 seconds clear of Ayaguirre. Alex Marquez is looking on, thinking I wouldn't mind having a race like Aaron Canet a bit later on this afternoon. So this was the first track limit for Aaron Canet earlier on. That was at turn 10. This is the second one then at turn 17. Oh, there's third one, actually, so we've not got the second one. That's the third one. Katsuki Suzuki also doing the same, and that's the team just saying, stay calm, Aaron. Don't make any mistakes.
Yeah, well, at the moment, he's riding absolutely brilliantly. When you think about what he's had to deal with over the last couple of rounds, hit by Albert Arenas in Silverstone when he was going well, mechanical last time out in Misano, cost him crucial World Championship points. This is a champion ride by Aaron Canet for me. This is what makes world champions, when you've had a couple of bad races, when the chips are down, to come back and ride and win in this kind of convincing, emphatic fashion. This is a statement from Canet.
It really is, and look what would happen to the championship if it stays like this right now. They would be locked on 182 points apiece heading into Buriram.
Arbolino, I mean, at one stage in this race, he was second hunting down Aaron Canet. Doesn't look like he's had the grip underneath him on the Honda today. Arbolino, very, very disappointing. He was trying to be the first Italian, as we mentioned at the start of the programme, to have five successive podiums in the Moto3 World Championship.
Foggia then up into second place. Great ride from the Sky VR46 Academy rider. Not seen him on the podium, what, since Thailand last year?
Almost last year.
A whole calendar year for him.
Yeah, he does love Aragon as well, doesn't he?
He's track limits again, though.
He was eighth here back in 2017 as a wildcard, wasn't he, Dennis Foggia? So there's an intense battle then raging now for second place. You can forget about Canet, barring a disaster. He's had a fantastic cruise to victory here in Aragon, but it's all about the battle of a second. Nagura from Foggia, and Lopez is right in there as well.
A trio of 18-year-olds here battling for podiums. Two of them have never been on the podium, but the man who goes up into second there has been. He's had a taste of it already.
Aggressive that by Foggia up the inside of Nagura into turn number four. He did manage to hold it through turn number five. Agüero tries to fight back on the inside at turn seven, but Foggia says, you're not having that. He slams the door shut.
And look who's creeping up on them as well. John McPhee just getting close to that three, battling for the podium. Here is Aaron Canet. He's away with it. So it's Foggia, Agüero, Lopez, McPhee, Suzuki, and Garcia.
This is all about now the drive out of turn 15 onto that 1,000 metre back straight. The acceleration is going to be crucial. The slipstream, absolutely crucial. Agüero might not be badly positioned here behind Foggia because he'll be able to use the slipstream potentially on the Italian. John McPhee, has he got through on the inside of Lopez? No, he hasn't. Is McPhee just going to miss out on the podium here? It's all about the slipstream, the drag out of turn number 15. Who's going to get the best drive, who's going to be sweetest on the throttle? Here we go then, down the back straight for the final time.
You've got to try and get good position. That was a good exit from Dennis Foggia, it has to be said, but Ayagura trying to get through on him. Aaron Canet will be looking at the checkered flag shortly. Who's going to take second and third, though? There's a big group here, all slipstream. Ayagura there has the inside line. Alonso Lopez is coming through as well. Will Foggia lose out?
He's riding around the outside of Agüero. Here comes McPhee up the inside of Alonso Lopez. Canet's going to cruise to victory.
Brilliant win for Canet at home here. A masterclass from him. But who takes second and third across the line? It is Ayagura with a maiden podium and much deserved. Dennis Foggia returns to the top three steps as well. McPhee just misses out. Lopez will be crying again in fifth.
Manuel Randa Lopez, local council president, hands over the race winner's trophy to Valencia's Aaron Canet, the 19-year-old, 17th career podium in his 67th start, his sixth career Grand Prix victory, and he's right back firmly in championship contention.